हरे कृष्णा, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्रील प्रभुपाद। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द क्वालिटीज एंड करेक्टर ऑफ श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर प्रभुपाद, विच इज़ बेस्ड ऑन प्राइमरली बुक रिटन बाय श्री भक्ति विकास स्वामी। एंड दिस बुक इज़ बेसिकली इन थ्री वॉल्यूम्स। सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फ्रॉम वॉल्यूम वन, पार्ट टू, चैप्टर वन। वाई वी शुड डिस्कस द क्वालिटीज ऑफ प्योर डिवोटीज, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू डिस्कस, बिकॉज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट इज़ वेरी प्लीजिंग टू कृष्णा। इफ़ यू डिस्कस द क्वालिटीज ऑफ कृष्णा, कृष्णा बिकम्स हैप्पी ऑफ कोर्स। बट इफ़ यू डिस्कस द क्वालिटीज ऑफ हिज डिवोटीज, प्योर डिवोटीज, ही बिकम्स इवन मोर हैप्पी। Now, as far as pure devotees are concerned, first of all, their character, their qualities are profound and unfathomable. It is very, very difficult to even discuss a fraction of their qualities. But and they display very diverse qualities. For example, if you see Sri Ramanand Rai, he showed by his own example that he has conquered his senses. He was applying oil on the beautiful bodies of the devdasis, the ladies working and serving Lord Jagannath. He was himself personally decorating their bodies. He was touching their bodies. His heart was devoid of kama vasana. He was always in full control of his senses. If you talk about Shri Damodar Pandit, Shri Damodar Pandit, he was famous for objective criticism. Once Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was playing with a boy who was a child of a widow in Puri. And when Damodar Pandit saw that, he told Mahaprabhu to stop doing that because it may raise question on his character. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu graciously accepted and he stopped seeing that boy. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu even sent Damodar Pandit to Navdeep to help the devotees in Navdeep. That is the extent of his character, Damodar Pandit. If you see Haridas Thakur, four parents, he was beaten in 22 marketplaces, yet his faith was not wavered. He was even thinking about those soldiers who were beating him. And when the soldiers told him, if you don't die, the king will kill us. Then Srila Haridas Thakur, he went into Samadhi and gave them an impression that he is dead. You look at Sanatan Goswami, Rupa Goswami, they were the personification of meekness and humility. They went, when they first met Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Malda district, Ramakeli, they placed a blade of grass in their teeth. And from a distance, they offered obeisances to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told them that your humility is breaking my heart. Please stop doing that. That is the extent of their humility. So how do you see the quality of our Srila Prabhupada, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada? So as His Holiness Bhakti Vikas Maharaj describes in his books, that Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, he was a revolutionary. He changed the consciousness of the people in modern times. And in modern times, he showed how Krishna consciousness can be practiced. And at a scale which is unprecedented, he preached Krishna consciousness. It has never happened before. And now coming to Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, his qualities, his staunch, tenacious in the sense that once he will start some project, whatever obstacles will come. And in fact, he will give quotations from the scriptures saying that in any auspicious work, any work, good work you do, there will be a lot of obstacles. So all you have to do is don't be bewildered, don't be overwhelmed with these obstacles. Just continue to have full faith in the protection of Lord Krishna and continue to serve. The project will definitely be completed, and that's how it happened every single time. Besides that, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur embraced, imbibed the qualities of Gaur Kishorodas Babaji Maharaj, which are renunciation and bhajan. He was completely renounced. You look at his activities when Bhakti Vinod Thakur sent him from Puri to Navdeep, and there in Mayapur he was doing bhajan, how he was observing Chaturmasya, the way he was living with no proper roof. During rains he will hold an umbrella because the roof cannot check the rains, and he will continue chanting his japa. That is the extent of his renunciation and his bhajan nishtha. So a question may arise that well these different qualities means what? That there are different people. Are they giving different message? They are just like flowers in a garden. If in a garden there is only one type of flower, then it may look nice. But if that garden is full of different varieties of flowers, it will look even more beautiful. That's how we should see different qualities of different pure devotees. Now, even though they display different characters, yet there are three qualities that you will find common in all the pure devotees, especially coming in our sampradaya, all the Rupanukas. First quality is that they will have full faith in the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The second is that they will have full faith in the mercy, in the protection of Lord Krishna. This is called Brahm Nishtha. And the third is Shrotriya. Shrotriya means the person has, they will have full faith in the scriptures, and they will be super expert in the scriptures, to explain the scriptures to others. Well, you can say that, well, Gaur Kishorodas Babaji Maharaj was illiterate. So how can you say that he was expert in the scripture? Even though he was illiterate, yet he was well aware, he was conversant with all the teachings, all the essence of all the scriptures. And Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he acknowledged that fact, even though he himself was called living encyclopedia. When Sanatana Goswami was living in Puri at Siddh Bakul with Haridas Thakur, so Sanatana Goswami spoke one verse to Haridas Thakur. He said, Achar Prachar Namer Kara Dui Karya Tumi Sarva Guru Tumi Jagatir Arya. That there are people who practice devotion but don't preach, and there are people who preach but don't practice. Well, you are a person, Haridas Thakur. You are a person who practices himself as well as he preaches to others. You are the guru of the entire world. This is completely applicable to Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur also. He is a Nitya Siddha devotee of Lord Krishna, yet he showed immense faith in sadhan bhakti. He was doing his Gayatri Mantra regularly. He would wake up every day before everyone wakes up, attend regularly all the aartis. He will attend, he will chant in japa regularly. Why he was doing that? First reason is he was doing that to uplift neophyte devotees. And the neophyte devotees, they when they will see Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, their own guru, following that rules, so the regulations, they will also be inspired to do that. And second is to induce faith in his disciples and public at large, that this is the process. And the third is to shun, to discard the prakrit sahajiyas, the cheap pseudo devotees who think that devotion is very easy, who think that to have a siddh day, a spiritual body, is very easy. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, by his own example, he showed that through sadhana bhakti, you gradually raise yourself to raganuga bhakti, and from there you enter into ragatmika bhakti. It is not that you straight away go to a guru and the guru tells you, well, you are this manjari or that manjari, and you start doing mental service, mansi seva. Bhaktivinoda Thakur actually told that adhikarna labhya siddhate bhave viparaya janme buddhi shakti rabhave. If you do not have adhikar, if you do not have the qualification, and yet you act on that platform, wrong conclusions will arise in your mind, it will disturb your mind, and you will fall. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur showed by his own example this. Our scriptures talk about Krishnarthe Akhil Cheshta. All the activities must be performed to satisfy Lord Krishna. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he was doing whatever he will do, he was doing only to satisfy Lord Krishna. He was not interested in taking a sea bath in Puri. He was not interested going to holy places to take bath there. In fact, he thought that these are distractions in his goal of bhajan, preaching and writing. That was the extent of his single-minded, one-pointed attention to please Lord Krishna. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, in the context of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it is mentioned, sthavar jangam dekhe na dekhe tar murti, sarvatra hai nij isht dev sphurti. Wherever Mahaprabhu used to see, whatever Mahaprabhu used to see, he was, everything used to remind him of his worshipable Lord, Sri Radha Krishna. Same qualities Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur also displayed. The mutt had, you know, fields to grow crops. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, when he will see the crops growing, he will immediately remember Sri Radha Krishna. Well, this food from these fields, they will be used in the service of Krishna. Whenever he will see the plow, he will remember Sri Balram, who holds the plow. Whenever Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur will go to any mountain like Mussoorie, like Shillong, for preaching activities, whenever he sees mountains, he will immediately remember Govardhan. That's the kind of consciousness Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati had, and he gave to others. One of very important teachings of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is that when Krishna gives himself to somebody, pleases Krishna. Krishna gives himself to that devotee, but he will not give himself fully. But when a devotee gives somebody Krishna, he gives Krishna fully. Complete Krishna he gives. Krishna se tomar, Krishna dite par tomar shakti aache. Krishna is your property. You have the capacity to give Krishna to one and all. And because of this reason, a pure devotee the dust of the lotus feet of pure devotee is the most worshipable object in this material world. Last quality of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, that before the time of Bhakti Vinod Thakur, after the disappearance of Lord Chaitanya, everywhere this false propaganda, this false notion, people started believing that Krishna Bhakti is for weaklings. Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, by their scholarly discussions on Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam and various other scriptures, they established that Krishna Bhakti is not for weaklings, it is for scientific minded people. And what people think, you know, that the devotees, they are crying every time, they prove that, well, this is a scientific process and this is because of the testing of higher rasa. So while Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur was proving that that devotee is not a weakling, yet he displayed extreme humility. He would never allow anybody to touch his feet. Even his disciples couldn't touch his feet. Whenever anybody would try, including small young children. I mean, anybody allows children to touch their feet, but Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur will never allow. Anybody tries to touch his lotus feet, he'll say, no, no, not required. Dasasmi, I am your servant. Why should you touch feet of your servant? With that humility, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, with staunch and focused preaching, he changed the landscape of India and the whole world. So we will stop here. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna.